وصحبه اجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمه الله.
So brother Akil has asked me to say a few words and I'm hoping everybody's eaten enough that they're not in a rush to go back and eat again. So and what I want to start with is this idea about the month of Ramadan. That when Allah Ta'ala in the Quran speaks about the month of Ramadan, He says in the one verse in the whole Quran where Allah Ta'ala talks about Ramadan, He says He gave it to you لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, so that you could be grateful. So that you could be grateful for the gifts that Allah Ta'ala has bestowed upon you. And one of the verses in the Quran, because today this is a football tournament, and in football you want to have fun and you run around. Like the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ, they would wrestle and they would do archery and they would do horse racing and they would do sports and they would smile and they would laugh. But Allah Ta'ala tells us in the Quran that وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَضْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى, that He is the one. Allah Jalla wa Ala is the one. He is the one who makes you smile and He is the one who makes you cry. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَى, and He is the one who gives death and He is the one who gives life. And this is one of the most incredible things. And we, as a Muslim community in this town, have experienced much sadness over the last year and a half. There are people probably in this congregation now who have lost family members due to COVID. Maybe a parent, maybe a grandparent, somebody dear to them, that Allah Ta'ala, in His infinite wisdom, decided to take them away. Because He knew better for them than we know for them. And so Ramadan is a time to count the blessings that Allah Ta'ala has given you. The incredible blessings that Allah has given. Because, like Imam Al-Ghazali says, that there are two types of people on this planet. There are people that Allah Ta'ala has given blessings to. And there are people that Allah Ta'ala has placed in need. And the reason is that those people with blessings, their job is to take care of the people in need. And if they fail to do so, then Allah Ta'ala will place them in need. That Allah Ta'ala in an instant can turn the tables. And so one of the things about Ramadan, about the Messenger of God alayhi salatu wasalam, that they say he was the most generous of people, but he was at his most generous in the month of Ramadan. That when they would talk about the generosity of the Messenger of God, they would say nobody asked him for anything except he gave them what he had. And we know that he had nothing to give, but he would always give. But in Ramadan, he became even more generous. And so we recognize the gifts that Allah Ta'ala has given us, that we have a responsibility to be generous with the gifts that Allah has given us. And one of the greatest gifts that Allah has given us, without a shadow of a doubt, is the gift of Islam. Right? Because now, suddenly, people all over this country, all over Europe and America, they're suddenly having to come to terms that there's a thing called death. People really struggled with COVID because now they know that in an instant Allah Ta'ala can take their lives away, and they really struggle to come to terms with that. But the believer doesn't have this struggle, because tuhfatul mu'mini al-maut, that death is the gift of the believer, because it is his chance to be reunited with his Lord as he was once united with him Jalla wa Ala. And so we have to recognize that Islam, that the deen that Allah Ta'ala has given us, is a blessing from the blessings of Allah Ta'ala. And we recognize the way we live, the blessings that we have. Yesterday, I assume many people are aware of what happened in the holy city of Jerusalem, in Masjid al-Aqsa, where last night, in the 26th night of the holy month of Ramadan, the Muslim worshippers were attacked by the Israeli army while they worshipped. And this last week has been a week of attacks on our holy land, a land very beloved to Muslims. And we heard news that a 16-year-old was killed, was martyred. This, what the charities were giving for the Palestinians, that their struggle literally is to be alive. Their life is a struggle. And we're giving for the Uyghurs, those Muslims in East Turkestan, where I heard a story about a man who was in prison and he fasted. They caught him fasting and they gave him 15 years. 15 years. These are not 15 years in a prison in the UK where they give you a TV and a PS5 and they give you a massage and they give you a gym. And these are the most horrific prisons that you can possibly imagine. And Allah Ta'ala tells us that when He gives you a gift, He has conditions. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. He makes an announcement. Allah in the Quran says, Allah, your Lord makes an announcement that if you are grateful for the gift, then I will give you more. I will give you more reasons to be grateful. وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ. And if you are ungrateful and you complain, إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Indeed, my punishment is very severe. That if you want to complain, then I'll give you reasons to complain. Recognize the gifts that Allah Ta'ala has given us. And another thing, we're here commemorating the 313, this tournament, the 313. That there were once 330 men that Allah chose to defend the religion of Islam against the forces of evil. And these were people who gave us the faith with their blood. 14 martyrs at the place of Badr. One of them was only 16 years old, Umayr ibn Abi Waqqas, that his brother says about him that he was so small that I had to tie his sword to his leg so he wouldn't fall over. But he wept because he wanted to go and defend the religion so he could put it into our hands. And how have we received the gift of faith that those people gave their lives to give us? How do we honor their legacy? What have we done? Like the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a gathering not unlike this with his companion, he said, لَا تُسَوِّدُوا وَجْهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Don't embarrass me on the day of judgment. Don't embarrass me on the day of judgment. That they'll come and they'll say, Asim, who lived in High Wycombe, he blocked this guy off when he was driving. Or he had a mattress and he didn't know where to chuck it, so he decided to chuck it in the middle of the road. And he caused inconvenience to his neighbours. Or he had a neighbour who had no food to eat and he didn't give him anything. لَا تُسَوِّدُوا وَجْهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Don't embarrass me on the day of judgment. That before we can talk about the problems of the Palestinians and the Uyghur Muslims, and those are problems, that we have a responsibility to our own community. To make our communities, communities that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like the companions used to say, maybe Allah will show you something from us that will be a coolness to your eyes, O Messenger of Allah. And maybe we can also be one of those communities. So my lesson, my point today is a day of gratitude. Today is for the blessings that God has given us. And we recognize the sacrifices of those people who put the blessing of faith into our hands. And we recognize the sacrifices of people like Atiq. May Allah bless him. Because he's a man of service to his community and he's an inspiration. And he's not going to like this. And he's recording it, so that's just too bad. But this is an incredible blessing. We have people who are willing to fight for our community when we're not willing to fight for them ourselves. So we pray to Allah on this blessed night of Ramadan. We ask Him to ease the suffering upon the Muslims all over the world, wherever they may be. We ask Him to ease the suffering upon the humans of this planet, wherever and however they may be. We ask that Allah makes us a community that is a goodness to its people. We ask that we are a community that invites people to our faith and doesn't scare them away. And we ask Allah Ta'ala to bless those great martyrs who fought at the Battle of Badr so the deen could reach our hands. And we ask Allah to make this a gathering that joins the bonds of brotherhood and doesn't cause disunity. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen, wa salamun ala al-mursaleen, wa alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.